Craig Hopkins Installation Center here in Cleveland, Georgia. Because we're doing this as a tech article and you're probably doing it at home, I've elected to do two things. Splice the back of that wheelhouse in and splice the bottom of the drop-off in. Now you can replace them all, but I'm here to tell you it's a lot of work to get the whole wheelhouse in the car and it doesn't really need it. So I've laid the tape out where I can cut the bottom of the car below the line, and I've laid this tape on the new part above the line. I'm not gonna lap weld it, I'm gonna butt weld it. But when I put it up there, it's a lot easier to scribe the part you're using onto what it's gonna be joined to. Makes it a lot easier to put them together. Now, I'm figuring we're about the equal distance down. I know that'll work. There's a little bit of slip in the bottom with the quarter panel anyways, so we'll just go ahead and cut that off line for line. So I'll do the cutting, we'll get back to it. Okay, so you can tell if you want to butt weld two panels together, it's easier to fit the one that you're going to use to the other panel and make your scribe lines like I just did. Then, if you needed any little sneaking up on it, you can just use the grinder to trim just a little bit to get the fit you want. I have my scribe lines laid out. I'm going to make those cuts, put the parts up, tack them, make sure everything's working, and weld it together. There's a technique to butt welding on sheet metal, and I'll give you that tip when I get there. Couple more quick tips. I'm going to use a spot welder, so the backside panels have to be cleaned. I can't get in here with my grinder, but I have a media blast cabinet, so I'll just go in and blast it out. A wire wheel or something else would work in there. You just got to get creative sometimes. One more thing about putting this panel to this panel. There is a lot of undercoating in this wheelhouse on the back side. I'll get the torch and a scraper and remove that, because if I don't, it's just going to be on fire and make a mess. The weld through primer goes to the mating surfaces that mate against each other inside, not the surface you're going to weld on. This surface mates to the drop off. Doesn't take a lot. Nice light coat. This surface to quarter panel to the wheelhouse. You know, the secret to the butt welding is a perfect fit. That's why we scribed it and ground it. Got to be pretty darn close. This is all about control. So what I'm going to do is tack the panel in place as I'm moving it in and out to get that perfect flush alignment. Once I have it tacked, the last tip I'll give you when I start welding it together. But really, it's in the tack up and how flush you can keep the panel. We're using 023 wire. It's a lot easier to control with thin metal. Okay, now that it's in place, we're going to have to manipulate the panel in and out. Sometimes a thin screwdriver helps a lot too. jacked and flush, keep it flush all the way. You may be asking yourself why I didn't cut it up here on this line and make it easy for myself. Simply because when I get on the backside, I'll be able to grind the weld and make it disappear. If it's in the corner, it's very difficult. That's why I spliced it low. But I like to keep it nice and tight to any bend in the car, crown line if you will. It holds the panel straighter as I weld it. So I'm going to do a couple more tacks, and we're going to talk about how to butt weld this together. Here's a trick to butt welding panels together. Once you have it tucked and flushed where you like it, then I'm going to weld in one direction only. In small welds, maybe 3 or 4 beads. And then I'm going to use the air to cool the weld down and continue progressing in one direction only. If you skip around and the panels come out of alignment, you can't fix it. If the heat's only going one way, the panel's going to work all the way for you. You can control the whole thing. If you skip around, you get a knot in the middle, you're done. You've already got something in there you can't get out. Again, small welds, cool it down. Small welds, cool it down one direction. Thing you may notice that I'm pushing the weld, I'm not pulling it. I'm using the torch to push it instead of drag it. Now I'm going to weld the wheelhouse piece on that we did, butt welding it the same way, but I'm going to leave it loose where it attaches to the drop off, just in case I have to have a little bit of tilt back into the quarter panel. When I'm done putting those together, I'm going to come back with some E-coat in a can and seal these up. If I was into concourse restoration, I would finish this side off, but you can't look around the corner that well anyway. So. Plus, I like to leave a little extra weld in there. It's a little more structural. The backside, sure, trim it up, run your plastic filler on it, nobody's the wiser. like anything that's not exactly the same shape, you're going to have to work it a little bit. I noticed that I can probably get it up here and get a tack in it right there. It's where it helps to have somebody help you a little bit, but if I can get that done, then I can work the two surfaces together, realizing this is going to go back and forth a little. Okay, what I'm going to do is put the screwdriver between the panels, and then using the screwdriver I can flush them up, allowing me to tack it together. Then I can put it where I want it. Okay, I'm flush all along here. I'll put the tacks there. This I'm going to drive just a little bit. We'll fix that corner and away we go. It's easier to lift the bottom panel and try and push the top panel down. Butt weld the same way, cool it down. Hope we got enough flexibility here when we come around. I know it's going to tighten up the corner a little bit, but I think it'll move. If it doesn't, I can take the quarter panel back off, make a cut here, and make the adjustments I need to. This is spray E-coat. It works really well. I can seal inside of here and walk away from it.